So then Nicholas and I sat down together. You ready, sound man? We're about to start. And we put together a CD, as they say nowadays. We burned a CD. But to illustrate the various ways in which Jesus says we meet him in the world. So we're going to start with prisoners, visiting the prisoner. And I want to suggest here that if your church, the church you belong to, the one you stay away from, or whatever church it is, if you don't have a ministry, a lay ministry or anything, to visit prisoners, you are missing a very key ingredient of what it is to be a follower of Jesus and to meet him in the world. Nothing could be clearer. You've got to work into your church's program, into your own life, visiting those who are sitting there behind bars. Don't start out by judging them, saying they must have done something wrong, or they wouldn't be back here like that. That's not what Jesus is talking about. He's talking about those who are in prison, and he's saying when you visit them, you visit him in prison. That's how you meet him. So what would be a better way to illustrate this than to listen to one of my favorites, and I think it might be Jesus' favorite too. This is Johnny Cash. And he's singing Folsom Prison Blues, just to remind us of this one aspect of what Jesus expects us to be and to do. Ready?
And time keeps dragging on. But that train keeps rolling all down the side and home. When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. But I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die.
What do you mean? Okay, we can ease that off a little bit, sound man. That's good. See, we tried this all in advance, and we know how to signal each other here. It's very subtle. I yell over at him, and he does what I tell him to do. Thanks. Now, there's something else that is pretty clear throughout the Bible about how one serves God, how one serves and follows Jesus, and it has to do with strangers. Strangers in the land. The exhortation to be kind, be hospitable to the stranger. It comes from way out back in the Old Testament days when God said to his people in the Old Testament, you should look with kindness and treat with hospitality the strangers who are in your land because you were once strangers in the land of Egypt. They were later strangers also in Babylon. They were captives in Babylon. Now, one of the most important ways to follow Jesus today, both as an individual and as a church, is to know that in our midst here in America today, there are lots and lots of people. Some of them come from across borders here. Some of them come from close by to our cities and are homeless They're strangers. They're strangers in our cities. They're strangers in our land. And we often turn pretty much of a cold shoulder to them. And it's painful to be reminded that turning a cold shoulder to these strangers in our lands and in our cities is, in fact, turning a cold shoulder to Jesus himself. Jesus often comes to us as the undocumented person, the stranger, the immigrant, the poor person that we see as we walk down the street who's asking us for a little handout or who's shivering somewhere. Now, thank God, in the United States of America, we have thousands and thousands and thousands of churches that open their doors and heat their basements for people who would otherwise be very cold. Now, up where I come from, it gets very cold. In fact, I just talked to my wife this morning. She said, it was snowing. I said, well, it's not snowing. It's snowing in Alabama, I guess. She said, well, it's snowing up here. And she called it a freak storm. I said, no, Nina, look, it's starting winter in New England. It's not a freak storm. It may be a little unusual, but freak, no, it's not that. It gets very cold. Our church and many of the churches in our city have shelters for homeless people. We have food for them. We have a place where they can take a hot shower. We welcome them as we would members of our own family and make them, insofar as possible, a part of who we are. So I tried to think, what would be a way of illustrating this point for you using music that I am becoming increasingly convinced as I talk about it that Jesus would like? Well, some of you know this song about being an exile in Babylon. It's by the waters of Babylon. There we sat down. It comes from a psalm in the Old Testament. The Jewish people found themselves in exile in Babylon, and they're sitting out there hundreds of miles from their homeland in exile, undocumented, if you will. And the people who live in Babylon are kind of egging them on, and they're saying something like, hey, let's hear one of the songs you used to sing back home. It's kind of ridiculing them a bit. Like, come on, sing something for us. And their response is, look, how can we sing? How can we sing the Lord's song in a strange land? But, of course, the answer is they did sing. And they sang and they sang and they kept their spirits up and they kept waiting for God to deliver them, which eventually he did. They were able to come back to their homeland. But while they were there, they were exiles in a strange land, looking for somebody to welcome them as God had told them to welcome the stranger in their land. So we're going to listen to this now, and as we listen to this wonderful kind of reggae, some of you like reggae. Is that still something anybody listens to? Or am I just different? You like reggae. You like Bob Marley and some other people like that. Reggae also carries with it some very good, it's good music, but also some wonderfully spiritually significant words if you listen to it. And this one has them. This is a reggae setting, really, of the psalm that I just quoted. You ready, sound man?
Where?
Okay, we can cut back on that, thanks. People who carried us into captivity required of us a song. How can we sing the Lord's song in a strange land? Not easy to do. There's another whole group of people that I think we need to be thinking about when we think about being followers of Jesus. That's what he asks us to be his disciples, his friends. He actually said to his disciples, you know, don't call me master. Call me friend. So let's be friends. Be his friends. And that has to do with people we all know and run across now and then who don't seem to have many friends. I'm talking about lonely people. We all know them. You know that person in your class in school that everybody kind of ignores or shuns, maybe even makes fun of them. Maybe they have something that's people ridicule, and they feel excluded. Now, I think if you want to be a follower, a serious follower of Jesus, you're the one who initiates some kind of contact, some kind of friendship, just a smile, a greeting to the person who's normally pushed out over the edge. Everybody knows these people, in your office, in your laboratory, in your classroom. Think about the person, and you're probably thinking about that person right now, who could use just a little gesture from you that would perhaps make that person's whole day, as they feel at least welcomed and smiled upon, spoken to by somebody. Now, maybe this will expose you to some ridicule or some isolation by some of the people who are isolating that person. But that's the risk you run. Now, I tried to think about what song it is that would illustrate this point. And I have to say I dipped back pretty far into the classical repertory of popular music, and I don't think there's anybody here, no matter how young or how out of it, who hasn't heard of the Beatles. Now, the thing about the Beatles is they sang all kinds of music, but again, if you listen to the lyrics carefully of some of the Beatles, you will hear some spiritually significant music, and this is one about lonely people and how lonely people need us. You all remember the song. I think it's called Eleanor Rigby. And I'm going to play it. And think of, when you listen to this song, maybe for the first time, as you listen to Eleanor Rigby, think about that person or persons in your own life, in your own environment, who is the Eleanor Rigby, who is shunned, who is overlooked, and how you can make a difference in that person's life. Okay?
Up the rice in the church where a wedding has been. Lives in a dream, waits at the window, wearing the face that she keeps in a jar by the door. Who is it for? All the lonely people. Where do they all come from? All the lonely people. Where do Father Mackenzie, writing the words of a sermon that no one will hear. No one comes near, look at him working, darning his socks in the night when there's nobody there. What does he care? All the lonely people, where do they all come from? All the lonely people, where do died
window. It's a very sad song when you hear it. When you listen to the lyrics of that song. She died, Eleanor Rigby. Nobody came.